Hi, my name is Katrina, and happy World Snake Day. I'm here to talk to you about one of our native snakes here in the Mojave Desert called a sidewinder. So when you look at this animal, you can see his coloring is brownish and his pattern is broken up. So that helps him really camouflage himself out there in the desert. So speaking of sidewinder, this animal gets his name by the way that they move across the desert. So what they do is kind of fling themselves across the sand. Now the reason they do that is, one, sand is really hard to walk across, and two, in the hot desert summer sun, the sand is really hot. So they have this way of moving where they lift most of their body off the sand, kind of fling themselves forward in a sideward motion, and then move in that direction. So that helps them really grip onto the sand, and it helps them reduce how much of their body is touching that hot sand. Now imagine you are out there walking on that hot desert sand. If you had your bare feet, would you put your feet flat down on that hot sand? You wouldn't. You would come up on your tippy toes. So this is like a sidewinder version of stepping on your tippy toes to walk across the hot sand. Now, if you're a sidewinder, you are a venomous snake, and it is a rattlesnake, so you have the rattle on the end of your tail. Now that rattle serves to kind of as a warning system. So if you're walking around in the desert and you hear something rattle at you, that's a sidewinder saying, hello, I'm here. Please walk around me. Don't step on me. I'm kind of scared of you and I don't want to bite you. I want to go in the other direction, but I want you to know I'm here. So they use that rattle as kind of a warning system. Now, they don't use that rattle to catch their prey. So what these animals like to eat when they're babies, they eat mostly small lizards. So we're in the desert, we have lizards everywhere. And when they start to grow up a little more, they change their diet a little bit and they start to eat small mice and other little desert rodents. Now, what's really interesting about rattlesnakes and this sidewinder is they are pit vipers. So they have these heat pits in the sides of their mouths that they use to kind of detect any heat coming off of the animals they want to eat. So we all give off what's called infrared radiation, and it's a light spectrum that we can't see with our eyes, but sidewinders can detect with those pits in the sides of their mouths. So once they kind of lay in wait, waiting for something to come by, and then when they can detect something small that's giving off heat, they can strike and they will eat that animal. Sidewinders, like I said, are venomous and they kind of rattle to let you know they're there. So that means you don't want to touch them. If you see them in the wild, count yourself lucky that you saw this amazing native animal. Snakes are a very important part of our native ecosystem here. So while they are a misunderstood animal and not everyone maybe appreciates them, having a little bit of knowledge as to what they do out there in the wild, how they're a part of our ecosystem, gives you a little more respect for them. Now, if you don't want to see them out in the desert, just come here, visit us at the Springs Preserve. We have several of them on our exhibit. You can get a little bit of closer look and a little appreciation for how beautiful they are. And have a happy World Snake Day. Thank you.